Hello, this is Connie Belden, and we're going to take a look at the Perpetual Inventory System, specifically FIFO. FIFO stands for First In, First Out. So that means by first in, the first merchandise inventory that you purchase will be the first inventory out to be moved to cost of merchandise sold as you sell it. This is important because a lot of times when you buy merchandise inventory, you could be buying it at different prices. Typically, it's a higher price because prices have a tendency to go up, but it could be a lower price as well, such as gasoline goes up and down all the time in price. So as you sell it, that's the purpose of the inventory systems, is to determine how much of that cost stays in merchandise inventory, how much moves on to cost of merchandise sold. So we're going to use cell phones as our example. Let's assume on May 1st that we have an inventory, that's the same as our merchandise inventory, 5 units that we paid $100 each for, so $500. I did is I made a merchandise inventory count over here, and the X's represent the 5 units that I paid $100 each for. Now, on May 10th, I bought 10 more units, but the price has gone up to $110 for a total of $1,100. So over here, I have 10 O's representing the 10 units that I paid $110 for. This now becomes part of my inventory because I have not sold anything yet. But what I want to do first of all, as you see by my arrows, is I want to bring down the 5 units that I bought at $100 and keep that at the top because those are the first units that I bought. Those will be the first units when I sell any cell phones to go to cost of merchandise sold. And then I'll bring over below it the 10 units that I just bought at $110. Now is where we're going to do a sale and gets a little tricky. Let's assume that on May 12th, we sold 8 cell phones, 8 units. Now remember, FIFO means first in, first out. The first units in were the 5 that we paid $100 for. However, we sold 8 of them, so we would still need 3 more. So what we're going to do is we're going to take 5 at $100. We're going to use those up. Then we'll go down to the next level, and we'll take 3 of them at $110. So again, I'm going to take all 5, so I'm going to put in cost of merchandise sold that I sold 5 units. The $100 was the cost. For $500, okay? Now, remember, I sold 8 in total, so 8 minus 5, I need 3 more units. So I'll put 3 units, and the next level down is $110. Okay, so 3 units at $110 is $330. So together, that's the 8 units, okay? Because 5 plus 3 is 8. Now, let's see what we have left in merchandise inventory. Let me go over here to my accounts. I sold all 5 of these at $100. So I'm moving those into cost of merchandise sold. Okay, that's what I did right here. I put the 5 at 100 into cost of merchandise sold. Now, of the ones at $110, and it doesn't matter which ones I take here, I sold 3 of them. So I'm going to take 3 out of the inventory and put 3 over in cost of merchandise sold. So notice now what I have. Okay. So notice now what I have is I've got 5 units at $100 in cost of merchandise sold. I have 3 units at $110 in cost of merchandise sold. And what do I have left? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 units at $110. Okay, so I have 7 units left at $110, or $770. Now, I drew it out here in the little chart so you could see it, but you could look at it here as well. Obviously, we got rid of all 5 of those, so that would be none left at $100. And then 10 units is what you had in inventory, minus the 3 you sold, then leaves you with 7. Okay, the next thing that happened, let's assume that we sold 4 more units. Now, in this case, there's only one price left, $110, and we have enough of them. Okay, so we sold 4 units at $110 for $440. Okay, now again, take a look at, you had 7 units. You sold 4 of them. 7 minus 4 leaves you with 3 at $110. Okay, if it helps you out, you can do it over here in the chart as well. We will take 4 of them out, move 4 of them over to cost of merchandise sold, and you see you have 3 left in inventory. Now, where I've highlighted in yellow, these are the numbers I'm going to add. So you want to add up everything in your total cost column for cost of merchandise sold. So therefore, this month, my total cost of merchandise sold is $1,270. Now, for merchandise inventory, it's what's ever left on your last transaction. So therefore, let's assume that I just had the $330 left. So merchandise inventory at the end of the month is $330. I hope that helps you out with the FIFO system. In the next video, we're going to take this information and we are going to do the LIFO system.